This video was inspired by a LinkedIn post from the amazing Astrid Hennekamp, who I interviewed last year on Cat Chats. It was a really interesting interview, which you can check out here. Now, there are lots of AI tools out there right now, many of them taking your image and turning it into something photorealistic. But there are also tools that take your image and turn them into video. And that's what we're playing with today. Welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication for fashion entrepreneurs on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. Now, I will tell you that today's video is more about the fun of it. Outside of a cool social media post, I'm not sure what practical purpose this serves. I mean, maybe something for e-com, but otherwise, doesn't do much for design development, but it's fun. And sometimes you should use some of these digital tools just for the fun of it. So that's what's happening today. I'm starting with a 3D avatar, but you should be able to use this with maybe something you've generated in AI. And I'm going to head over to clingai.com. The nice thing about using Cling, besides the good things I've heard about its finished AI video quality, is that you can use it for free. You have a certain amount of tokens that it assigns you each month, as long as you log in. So if you want to try it or create the occasional short video, it's perfect for you. Now, I was just trying to see what the buzz was about and if this thing really could do what people were saying it could. From the homepage, choose AI videos. Then in the options on the left, choose image to video. Keep it on frames and upload your image. What's also cool about this is you can add a start and ending frame. But for this, I'm just going to add the starting frame. Then, of course, you need to add a text prompt, my favorite part. Although the nice thing here is that this is optional. I'll quickly show you what it generated when I didn't put in a text prompt. And this is fine. She's not doing anything mind-blowing. So if you want your model to do something more specific, you'll definitely need to write it in the prompt. So I added a prompt, model walking into the foreground and off camera. I used the picture of the 3D avatar, no extra AI to make it more realistic. And this was the result. Not bad. The next time I used the picture of the 3D avatar, but ran it through an AI program to make it look more realistic. And this time I used the prompt, model walking forward towards the camera. Cool, right? Now I will tell you, this can get very addictive. I did another of my 3D avatars. And I definitely would have done more, but I ran out of free credits. Now these videos are short, the quality is okay, and of course they're watermarked. But if this is something you seriously want to do, like say you do want to have something like this on your e-com site, you definitely want to upgrade. Even the next tier up for a smaller fashion entrepreneur would probably be fine. You get many more credits, longer and higher quality videos, no watermark, and the video generation is faster. Although these videos take about 2 to 3 minutes to generate, which really isn't bad. So definitely check it out. It's pretty fun. Those of you playing with 3D these days, take one of your more recent renderings, drop it into Cling AI, and see what kind of fun videos you can create. And if you're playing with some AI tools that create a photoreal version of your design on a model, you can try it with that too. Thanks for watching today's video. If you're interested in playing with other AI tools, make sure you check out some of my other videos on this channel. And if you're interested in starting your journey into 3D fashion design software, make sure you check out my 3D course, which I'll link below in the description. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you found it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.